Hello YouTube, I'm Tallman Brad, and in this series I'm going to be gently guiding you through the very basics of getting started in Space Engineers, all the way to adding mods to make your own custom games with hostile enemies, and eventually to the point where you'll be confident in your game playing abilities to join a multiplayer server and not be instantly destroyed by other players or NPC ships. In this episode we'll start with navigating the game menus and setting up a basic game scenario. Then we land on our first planet and get a simple base established. Grab a drink, click like on the video, and let's get started. Let's have a look at the menu system here. You can see we can start a new game from here. We can load a previously saved game there. The next one, we can join an online game. Options where we can change the graphics and sound settings. Character where we can change our model and the color of the model. And obviously exit to Windows. If you have a quick look in character, this is where you could choose, there's my guy there, to be a male or a female astronaut, and you can customize how your astronaut is going to look with these options here. Now, these are all things that you collect in the game from free loot boxes that are a little bit of fun while you're playing the game. Next, we need to have a look at the options menu. And there we can see in the game options, these are the settings that I use. You can copy those if you like, or leave them as the default. The only thing I would say is that it's worth making sure that experimental mode has been selected. This will just let you use mods and other things later on in the game. I've turned off some of these other things because I just found they got in the way. Now these are things you can change as you play, so they're not essential to sort out at the minute. Next on display, these are my settings. Yours may look different. I like vertical sync on. I'm not a fan of screen tearing. Graphics. Now this is where you might want to spend a little time if you have a low-end or medium-end system. Quality presets are, as they suggest, if you have a low-end system, just go straight for low and you can come in and add things later to it. Same thing if you have high-end, you could go for the high setting and then you could reduce things later. But some quick tips here would be things that impact the frame rate, I found the most anyway, are the shadow quality. I have mine a medium, but you might want to just disable it. You'll gain quite a few frames from doing that. Grass density and draw distance, you can turn those down. And the tree draw distance, you can reduce that. That'll help speed up your frame rate. I'm not so keen on the image smoothing effects. I quite like a sharp edge, so I have anisotropic filtering low and anti-aliasing off. Audio, as it suggests, I have the music turned down. The music is very good in the game. Sound volume, I've got it on medium just because I'm recording. And voice chat if you're using the game's chat features to talk to other players, which you can turn on there. Controls, tweak your mouse sensitivity, and obviously the credits to see the developers' names and details. We want to start with a new game. In this first tab, we have some ready-made scenarios for you to play. Workshop is where you would load in scenarios made by other players. And then custom game is the one that we're going to use. You can see here there are a few options to choose from, but the one we want to choose to get us started is the bottom one where it says Star System. I'm going to select that. We can change the name here if we like. I'm going to call this YouTube Tutorial. Now these options here, creative, if you just want to play a sandbox game without having to do any mining for resources and you just want to pop pieces down and build things a bit like Lego, you can use the creative option. Survival is where we will actually have to mine resources and look after our health, oxygen, and so on. That's the game mode that we're going to be using. I'm going to be playing offline. I'll let it automatically save the game. And below that we can see we have the mods option and advanced. Now we're not going to go into mods today, that's a setting that we'll look at in another video. But we will have a look at the advanced options. Now don't be frightened, this looks a little bit intimidating, but it's not as bad as it seems. I'm going to leave most of these things on default, but there are some things that I want to change just to make the game that little bit easier to play in the earlier stages. First thing I'm going to change is the character inventory size. 3 times is what it's suggesting. I'm going to boost that up to 10 times for comfort. It means we can carry that little bit more without having to do backwards and forwards trips. Now the block inventory size is how much the objects or the items in your game world can hold. I'm going to increase that to 10 times as well, so they will store more than normal. Sound mode, I like arcade. This just means that you can always hear everything if it's within earshot of your character. Whereas if we put it to realistic, this means that in space, no one can hear you scream. In fact, in space, nobody can hear anything. Once you do get into space and you have your helmet closed and you're outside in the void, you can't hear anything at all. So any space battles that you get involved in are like silent movies. I'm not so keen on that. I quite like arcade. Sun rotation is turned on, which means we get day and night cycles, and that will happen every 2 hours. I'm leaving the rest of these settings as they are. So if we're happy with all of those settings, we'll just click on Start. So as we're starting in a space system, we have a few options. We have basically the whole galaxy to spawn in. We're going to go for the Earth drop pod. And we're going to click Respawn and see where it drops us. Now be warned, the game starts with you plummeting to Earth, in this mode anyway, in the drop pod. Your parachutes will open and you should land safely. However, you may land in an awkward place on the planet, or you may land upside down. At that point, don't panic. We'll just restart the game. And hit V and have a look around. Another quite mountainous area in a bit of a valley. Looks nice. This could be okay. Let's see what the landing's like. It's on the side of a hill. It's picturesque. But the terrain's pretty rough. And I'm hoping we're going to make a rover at some point. Let's see how it lands and we'll assess the situation. Oh, not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, let's jump out of the ship with F. And we're still in third person mode. If I hit V, go back to first person. Alright, so a quick tour around the ship before we get started. That was the seat we were sat in. At any point, if you start running out of power, you can jump back in the seat and get recharged. However, there's a quicker way of recharging by using the med kit at the back here, the survival kit. If I hold F while I'm looking at that, there's a little noise there, and you probably wouldn't notice, but in the bottom left of the screen, where we can see the lightning bolt, that is our energy. Our energy is used up by the suit's protection system from the elements and also from the tools that we use. We also top up our H2O system from there. That's our jetpack. How do we get the jetpack on? Just hit X to turn it on. Space will get us up in the air. Don't panic. C will bring us down, but be very careful because you can go quickly, and if you hit the ground fast, you will die. X to turn it off again. And there you go. So let's have a quick fly around. X, I'm going to push forwards. Zip around the place. Back to our ship. Just tapping W, not holding it down. X, because I don't want to crash into it too fast. On the bottom left-hand side, you'll also see the helmet there. That it's indicating that the visor's down. That means that we're breathing oxygen from our suit. We don't need to do that. We're on an oxygen-rich planet, if I can say that. So I hit J to open up my visor. If we have a look outside at our character, just zoom in, turn around. There we go. You can see right in the middle of the crosshairs, his visor is up. J closes it. At the side of the survival kit, you have access to the workings of the survival kit. If I hit F on that, on the left-hand side of the screen, that's my inventory. That's what I'm carrying, and you'll always have the basic grinder, hand drill, and welder. On the right-hand side of the screen is the contents of the thing that we hit F on. So it starts with the one that you've actually clicked on, which is the survival kit. Walking around the ship, we can see here, this is the access to the H2 generator. I click F on that, we can see inside of there we have an oxygen bottle, which we don't need at the minute. We have a hydrogen bottle, which is very handy, and the ice, which is topping up which will top up these bottles if we put them back in here. I'm going to take the hydrogen bottle because it's handy to have. Now your kit stores its own small amount of hydrogen, but putting a bottle on gives you that bit longer flight time. Now, if you do get injured when you're jetpacking around, as long as you don't die, you can go to the med kit and revive yourself there and top up your oxygen and H2. Let's hold down F. So there's no particular goal in this game. It's really just about surviving and building ships and bases and really doing what you want to do. But I'm going to set a target that my goal is to get to space. So to do that, we're going to need to build some form of a ship that will get us out of the Earth's atmosphere and into orbit around the planet. We have some very basic equipment here to get us started building things. Let's just have a quick look at that now. If I go F on the side of the survival kit and into production, we can see these are things that we can make at the minute. Well, these are things that we could make if we had the resources for them. Now, all of these things will take either iron, silicon, nickel, cobalt, and gold, silver, etc., as you go on. But at this basic stage, we just need to be able to make these few things to get us started. So we need to feed some materials into here to get them processed into a usable form. Now, this survival kit will take stone and convert that into iron and silicon and so on. So let's change to 3, which is our drilling tool. Now, I'm standing at the minute, but if I hit C, it'll drop me down closer to the ground, which makes it a lot easier to start the drilling. And there are two options for the drill, but the left click will gather the resources, and the right click will drill a larger hole without picking up the resources. Now we want to get through the grassy layer, through to the rock underneath, so I'm going to use a right drilling to get down that bit quicker. You can see we're at the grass layer still, and it's getting a little dark in the shade, so I'm just going to back up so you can see. And hit L on the keyboard to bring up my lights. And we're starting to get through the grass, so I'm going to keep going though. Right click, I'm still in the crouch position. That took some doing. So this is the sort of rock we want to gather, so I'm going to switch now to the left button, but I'm also going to hold down F on the keyboard, which is to collect. I'm just going to stop there. You can see the red line appearing along the bottom there, which is above our hotbar indicator. Now that was blue as I was gathering the stones, but as my inventory is filling up, it's turned red. But I've also dropped a few of these stones, so I'm going to pick those up with F, and that's probably going to fill up the rest of my inventory.
Inventory full.
There we go, we're full. So we've got plenty of rock. We need to try and get back out of here. And we'll drop this in the back of the survival kit to start the processing. So I'm going to hit F. Here's a survival kit with nothing in it. We have 10 kilos of stone. Let's drag that in. Now it's not doing anything yet because it doesn't know what we want to do with it. So if I go to production, I can now tell it that I want to make ingots. So if I click that once, that will process one lot. Now, it's not a great deal. And you can see underneath here, we've ended up with some gravel, some iron, nickel, and some silicon. The best way to do this is if you hold down Control and tap on ingots, you'll get 10. If I hold down Shift and tap on ingots, we'll get 100. Now I'm going to queue up a few. If it runs out, it doesn't matter. It doesn't complain or explode or anything. So I'm just going to throw in a few hundred requests. There we go. And let it get on with that. And in the meantime, while it's processing that stone, let's go and get some more. Now, if we hadn't increased our inventory size, we'd only be able to carry a small amount of this stone. So we would have probably had to do 6, 7, 8 trips for those 2 trips that we've done there. So it's just saving us a little bit of time. It's not really cheating. It's just, just speeding things up a little bit for you. So remember, you can just hold F while you're drilling Don't need to keep tapping it. Alright, so we don't want to be living out of this thing. What we want to do is we want to get a little base established. So how do we build things? Well, in the hotbar across the bottom there, you can see one is our welder. That's what we're going to use to construct things. Two for grinding, dismantling stuff. And three we've used already, which is the drill. Now four is the very basic building block. So I want to build a building block, but it's red at the minute, which means that I haven't got the components that I need to build it. If I try clicking the mouse button, no, it's saying we need steel plate. So where do we get the steel plate from? Let's go back to the survival kit and hit F, go into production, and there is our steel plate. Now we're going to need quite a few of these, so I'm going to tell it now to build 100 of these. So I'm going to shift, click on that. There's 100 added to the queue, but it's busy processing the stone that we dug up. So I want to prioritize the steel plates so I can get those sooner. If I just drag that over the top, it'll push that over. Now what will happen is when we run out of iron, it'll stop manufacturing these and it'll go back to processing the stone. And once it's processed enough stone to continue on with that, that's what it'll do. I can't pull the items out of here. We need to click on inventory. And there are the plates that we've asked it to make. I'm going to grab all of those by double clicking. And they're in my inventory now. Just like that. That'll do. So we've got a very basic and very weak base started, or first block of the base anyway. We can leave that as it is and just continue building around it. Or alternatively, we can pull out the welder and weld that up to a completed block. Now those blocks will be destroyed with one hit from any bullet fire or any enemy ship. So it's worth welding those up in those sorts of scenarios. But because we're in a sort of a peaceful scenario, it's not that important at the minute. Rather than using up all of our steel plates to weld that up, we'll just use the one that it takes to place the block so we can get a few of these blocks down. Like that. So what I need to do first is look at getting power generation going on the starter base. So there are solar panels, wind turbines. Those are the two starter things. Personally, the wind turbine is the quickest and easiest thing to get us going. Now there's an optimum place to put the wind turbines, and we're going to do that now. We need to place several blocks up high to get the wind turbine on the top. Now ideally, it wants to be around about 8 blocks, but we can't get up there like this. We haven't got ladders, so we're going to use the jetpack and keep an eye on our H2. So jetpack on with X, float up. We've got 2 blocks, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oops, put that in the wrong place. 7 and 8. So I've accidentally put that block there. I want to get rid of it. How do we do that? If I tap 2 and bring out my grinder and just very quickly, there we go, grind that off. Now, if I grind down here, this is the other problem with just having these unwelded blocks. If I grind there, one little tap of the grinder and the whole thing will come down. So now we want to place a turbine on the top of there. If we have a look at our hotbar, conveniently, number 7 is the turbine. Let's click on that. And we're going to test out what happens if we try to place it here. It's not happy. It's in red. If we go on the side of here, still not happy, it's in red. Now let's try and place it. Now it's saying we need interior plate to build the wind turbine. So where do we get interior plate from? Well, it's obviously in the survival kit. Let's go in there now and go to production and look for interior plate. There it is. Now if I hover over that, it tells me what we need to make the interior plate. Now in the middle of the screen, just over here, you can see it says we need iron ingot. We need one iron ingot and we have 530. So we've got plenty. So let's make a few interior plates. I'm going to hold down control to make 10 of those. And while it's on doing that, I'm going to go to inventory because I know I have to be there to pull them out. There we are. Let's double click. And we'll drop it on there. But obviously it's not doing anything yet. This does need to be welded up. So let's bring the welder out and click on it and see what we need. Now it's done so much there, but it's saying you need 8 motors. And if you could see that, production, motors. We need 8 of them, so if I do 10. Now this might seem like a long-winded way of doing it, and it is, but this is the way to get started when you're learning how the game works. Now that's the slowest, absolute slowest way of doing it, but it is the easiest way early on. I weld that up. It's used the 8 motors. Now it's complaining about construction components and it wants 20 of those. But if we have a look at the right-hand side of the screen where it says wind turbine components, construction components are in red. It needs 20, but it also needs 24 girders, 2 computers, and 30 more interior plates. So let's make some construction components. I think it was 20 girders. I think it was 24. So I hit Control twice to give me 20, and then click it individually 4 times. And now you see, I've already forgotten what else it needed. It needed more interior plates. I think it was 30. Let's get 30 of those. And there was something else, and I've forgotten what it was. So this is the problem. So to get around that problem, they have included this system called the Build Planner. Now, the Build Planner is a little bit complicated. It involves some different key presses to get working. So I'm going to go into more detail on that in another video. I want to keep this one as simple as possible and not scare you off straight away. So let's grab those components if they're made. There's the construction components, 24 girders. We'll take some of those up and we'll see what that other thing was that we're missing. There we go. I can see there it was 2 computers. You can just read that. So I need more interior plates and the 2 computers. Very carefully. There we are. So it's the rest of those when they're ready, but we also need 2 computers, and there they are. 1, 2. And there's the 30. Okay, and X back up there and start welding. And there we are, it's done. So now we're generating power, and that power is transferred through all of these blocks to whatever's touching these blocks. Whatever's built on them will be powered by that. Now, it doesn't provide a massive amount of power, but it certainly does enough to get us started. And it's just started raining. So far in this series, this is the first episode, we've looked at the menus, looked at the options for creating your own world, and we've made a start by landing our drop pod. And we've also made a start on a base, got a tower up, and got a wind turbine going. Next time, we're going to build a basic assembler and a refinery and see what else we can get done. But I'm going to leave it here for the minute. If you've enjoyed this video and found it useful, please hit the like button. Also, subscribe if you fancy seeing more of this series. Thanks very much for watching. I've been Tall Man Brad, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.